welcome. It's Kirsty here. So if you are somebody who experiences chronic pain, illness, or have a friend who experiences chronic pain or mental pain like anxiety, depression, then you need to stay tuned because I have got some insane information to share with you about a technique that I've been developing over the last 15 years that has had incredible life-changing results with not one drug taken. So before we dive in, don't forget to do press subscribe below and there's a little bell next to it, and also thumbs up, hopefully thumbs up, and do share, do like, do comments, say hi below, any questions, just throw them at me. I love answering questions. And yeah, just remember, if you know anybody else that who might benefit from this, do share this. At the end, I've got some super uber exciting news to share with you about some free course that I'm developing that is going to help people like yourself and others that you may know who may have at some point dabbled or had a bit of an issue with the word stress or the experience of stress. So stay tuned for that at the end. Okay, let's dive in. This show will transform your life from the inside out. So I have been on a massive journey for the last 15 or so years. It started off where my own life hit absolute all-time rock bottom. Found myself in a terrible situation, single mum, three under four-year-olds. I was homeless, penniless, bankrupt, and actually really kind of nursing some wounds from leaving a severely intense relationship, which left me feeling like low confidence and just no self-belief. But the most important thing about this is that at the time I was so self-critical on myself that if you'd have heard the things that were going on in my mind about myself, I'd have probably been arrested. It was violent, it was disgusted, it was hatred, it was thinking I was just such the worst person on the planet. And anyway, as life tends to have these silver linings, it was the catalyst to the start of what's got me to where I am today. And so I kind of started on this little soul-searching kind of process, looking after three small children. I was kind of looking for answers because I felt rubbish. And it was at that point I came across a guy called Tony Robbins, which I'm sure you've all heard of. Fabulous American tall chap who's insanely motivational. And I was so fortunate I managed to scrape enough money together and then went and did one of these courses called UPW. Which interestingly, I went back this year to crew it, so I worked it this year, which was a real circle of life, but I'll get to that in a minute. So anyway, I went and did this course, and fortunately I didn't know, because at that point I was really suffering with like feeling anxious and feeling like scared of life, and gosh, if I'd known when I got there was going to be 10,000 people there, I probably wouldn't have gone. But anyway, there was, and it was amazing. It was like he was talking to me individually, even though there was all these other human beings in the room. And I literally spent the whole 4 or 5 days with my jaw open, just completely bowled over with what he was sharing. And it was the starting point and a huge light bulb moment for me of what was possible. And it gave me hope. And I came back home and I finished my degree on the night course and I got a job and things started to turn around. But more importantly, I was on this course of life, this path of completely obsessed and wanting to know, read, listen, watch YouTube clips, TV programs. Well, this wasn't really TV programs, but it was YouTube clips, it was books, it was going to the library, downloading information from the internet, anything to do with like personal development and human behavior and what makes us become the best version of ourselves. And I just was absolutely bowled over by it. It fascinated me. And I think it probably was what was really important was that it gave me an opportunity to press the reset button and just go, I've got a second chance here. And it was at that point I was then offered to do I was working at that time as a business advisor, and they asked me to choose a CPD day. So a development program that was going to help me. And I came across a coaching program and went on a taste course, fell completely in love with it because, oh my goodness, this was a technique that allowed you to forget everything you'd done in your life up until that moment, which meant I could write off everything that I'd done, because at that point I deemed that as all bad, even though now I realize it's an integral part of my journey. And it meant that I could just press the reset button and bang, I could start again. So I fell completely in love with this process, because it just meant that not just people like myself, but anybody who felt that they wanted to just be catapulted from a fresh moment and become and sculpture themselves into somebody new, they could. And I was like, oh, this is exciting. So I flew through my course, flying colours, and was incredibly excited when I started to kind of have clients working with confidence issues initially. And of course, while I was on this journey myself, I was just using a lot of it on myself and increasing my own self-worth and confidence, etc. And I don't know, it just quite like, I knew that it wasn't the end of the road. I knew there was more. And at that point, I came across the Ashayas. So the Ashayas are the type of meditation, teach the type of meditation I do, which is called Ascension. It's called the Bright Path. .com if you want to go and look at the website, I'll put the link below. And this is a set of human beings that are mind-blowing. And I went to do my course, which is a weekend course, which I now teach because I'm now a teacher. And on that Saturday morning, I had my next light bulb moment. And I always describe it a little bit like this. It's like, life has always felt a little bit like a jigsaw puzzle, but there's always been one piece that could never find its way home. And on that Saturday morning, it went ka-chunk. And I just went, oh my God, this is what it's been all about. And had this complete overwhelm sensation experience of, for the first time in my life, really getting what life was about. And understanding that all this battling, all this fighting, and all this self-sabotage, and all this like this criticism and judgment and could stop. And it was so unbelievably refreshing and energizing and exciting. And it was like, oh my goodness, I have been spending so many of my years trying to change things on the outside of my life. And not for one moment had I realized that it had nothing to do with my outside, that I needed to change my relationship with me from within. And only when I started to do that with things on the outside and reflect it. So, as you can imagine, I fell in love with this and ended up going and taking my children out of school. We drove to Spain and we lived on and off the top of the Spanish mountain where I did my training with some Ashaya monks and learned about the workings of the mind and became obsessed with it, because I'd never ever dived into something as unbelievably dimensionally, multi-dimensionally mind-blowing. And I wanted to shout from the top of the mountain and tell everybody that everybody needs to know this, like what we're doing in educational systems, we need to change this, the kids need to be taught this, and blah, 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 blah. But realised that, you know, it wasn't going to make a difference, that the only difference that I was going to make is for me to go inwards again and start shifting that relationship to then be able to help and empower others. So that's what I did. And I graduated in 2015 as an Ashaya monk, which always makes me laugh because it's like, the word monk, but I think it's just because I've got some connotation to it that from upbringing that is religious and it's just so not. And while doing this, like I've been coaching and more people coming to me with sort of more physical and mental issues, like feeling anxious and feeling scared and feeling like they've got backache. And it was really interesting. So I was starting to watch like how come I'm manifesting all these people, and it's at that point I then went and did some training of the teachings of Dr. John Sarno, who is sadly he passed away last year with another one of the greats, Dave Hawkins. It was a bad year last year. And he was based in America, and he was the only guy, and I'm sure there are others, but the only guy that I come across who still treated his patients as a mind and a body. And I was like, oh my God, this man is incredible. Because for me, it was always obvious, especially once I started doing my training with the Ashayas, the mind and body were absolutely, completely one. And you know that's true, because when you're hungry, if somebody walks in with a beautifully baked apple pie or bread or whatever, your mouth will start salivating, not because you've got butter, but because your mind and body are completely connected. So he made so much sense to me. So I went into some of his trainings, techniques with the lady and in the UK, and things started to all start to fit together. So I kind of like learned all this mind-body stuff with the Ashayas. I started off with the motivation stuff with Tony Robbins, and then done my coaching, which mainly catapults me from here. And now I was looking at going into recognizing why we manifest illness or dis-ease or chronic pain or mental illness or whatever you want to call it. Why do we manifest it? And everything was starting to make so much sense, because literally we're born as blank canvas, we go through life, and what happens is the brain has been completely programmed to protect you. You know, it's gonna keep you alive at whatever cost. And sometimes that cost is at a later date, we pay for it. So for example, when we go through a stressful experience, you know, all sorts of chemical reactions happen within the body, cortisol fires off, adrenaline fires off, and that's how literally the cells of your body communicate. So it's a positive thing, because it needs to know whether you're upward spiraling, downward spiraling, and knows whether to be like in fight mode or whether to be like in chilled out mode. It's again to protect you. But too much of anything is never good. And like the human beings, what happens is if the experience is that intense, your brain makes a decision on its own. It goes, can little Johnny deal with this stress right now? If you can speak, of course. No, he can't. So it takes that emotion, if you imagine it, and it suppresses it into your subconscious. Now you have absolutely zero control over that. That is just a mechanism of the mind. And so if you imagine that we've all got these like rucksacks on our back and we're walking around all day long and we're all having experiences, and everybody's experience is different due to whatever programming we've got in our subconscious mind, a bit of a long word sometimes, depending on what that program is, depends on how we interpret things and how we react to things, and it's all so interlinked. But anyway, so you imagine the subconscious mind now rucksack on your back, we keep filling it up with this suppressed emotion. At some point, that rucksack is going to get full, and it's going to get so full it's going to have only one option, and that's to overflow. So if you imagine your subconscious mind is now full with suppressed emotion, it overflows. Well, what if the mind and body connected, where does it overflow? It only has one place to overflow to, and that is through into your body. So it turns up as anxiety, panic attack, it turns up as depression, it turns up as a knee pain, it turns up as back pain, fibromyalgia, and it turns up as psoriasis. It turns up as a common cold. You know, it doesn't matter that all of them represent a total different emotion anyway. So basically what happens is we fill up this rucksack, it overflows, and then what we've been taught to do is go to the doctor. Now, Western medicine is absolutely fantastic for certain things. So, you know, I 100%, if there was in a car crash and it's a life or death situation, 100% I'd be so thankful that Western medicine is here and it saved my life. But for long-term illness and dis-ease, it is nothing more than an absolute elastoplast, and in some cases it creates more harmful, prolonged symptoms because of the severity, because of the strength of the drugs that you're taking and the consistency of it, it impacts the body. So we've got it back to front. The only way that, so if we've got some physical dis-ease or illness or pain in our body, it's literally a representation of what's in our subconscious mind. Your body is a reflection of your subconscious mind. Your world is a reflection of it, period. So if you are manifesting some sort of illness, disease, pain, whatever, then literally what we need to do is we need to then switch it and go to underneath the pain and find out what has triggered it. Not deal with the pain itself, but deal with what has triggered it. So what I started to do is I started to collaborate all my learnings and teachings and trainings, and I started to see patterns in my clients. And I personally feel that life is one big pattern. So the pattern of what you do every day will equal an outcome. So if the pattern is somebody gets something, eats chocolates for a chocolate bar for breakfast and then has a kebab for lunch and needs to take over dinner and doesn't exercise, doesn't move, that pattern will equal, generally, someone who's overweight. So life is a pattern, but we're patterns too. And everything we've done becomes like imprinted in us, and then at some point it's communicated out. So I started to see personality traits in people and started to see like common things that all the same types of people would do that then would end up the same illness. It's insane. So like a fibromyalgia person, in my experience, they're usually creative, they're terrible at saying no. They've got loads of unconscious guilt or conscious guilt, and they they're really quite angry on a unconscious level. They're resentful because they're always doing everything for everyone else and never put themselves first. In fact, they probably can't remember or know how to put themselves first anymore. And so this then manifests at some point as pain. So until we deal with the root issue, the suppressed emotion, and we remove that, then people will not get better. So I collaborated all these learnings, and I developed a technique called the Ruby Davy technique. Ruby Davy is my Ashaya name, which was given to me when I graduated as an Ashaya in 2015. It means the goddess who removes pain. So I kind of thought, well, it kind of works. Might as well use it. And by the way, I didn't choose my name. It's given to you, and it's not given to you in your personality. It's given to you in the essence of who you are and your job, what you're meant to be doing well on this planet, which I thought was kind of cool. So I developed this technique, and so since the last few years, since 2015, I've been using technique for emotional and physical pain in my coaching process. I don't always use it, but it comes in handy a lot. And it's just about shifting people's perspectives so that they can heal themselves, really. All I do is guide them without the use of drugs. And meditation has been a significant part of this journey. And I still meditate every single day. I can't imagine that I won't meditate for the rest of my life because the impact is so massive. It has shifted so many things in my perspective, my world, and my inner and outer experience. But I've got a video all on that, so do go and watch that. So this is now called the Ruby Davy technique, and I use it in my practice. And I do have Ruby Davy practitioners who also use it. And it's super exciting because it's not anything new. This is really ancient. It's just in the collaboration of things that I've picked up along the way and I've amalgamated. So I'm not actually really creating the wheel. I've just listened and learned and pulled bits together and just create a process that just works. That's all. So if you've got any questions on that, absolutely love to hear them below. It's a little bit controversial what I do. Some people really don't like it. That's okay, I'm all right with that. If it helps one person, then I've done my job, and that's all I can say. So I am Kirsty, and please do leave in the comments below. But to my exciting news, nearly forgot. Also, don't forget to hopefully like or dislike whatever below, and do share, and do obviously subscribe and press the little bell. So my exciting news. So if you do know somebody who is currently experiencing any anxiety or stress issues, then I'm offering a free over five days course, which is gonna be on Facebook Live. It is an exciting time because it's gonna be an hour a day, where I will be teaching you and showing you some of the Ruby Davy techniques to be able to reverse your life or someone else's life that you know. It is completely free, and it's going to be, because it's the first time, there's gonna be a live Q&A session. So you'll get the opportunity to come along and ask questions, and if you are going through something, you've got a friend who's going through something, then completely and utterly, it'd be fabulous to hear your questions, and I'll endeavour to answer them. So do share that. Otherwise, don't forget to subscribe. Have a fantastic day, and I'll speak to you again soon.